I just seen it online, so I'm about to try busting every nigga ass online. Who, me? I never would've guessed. Rookie, but I do it like a man. I'm a man. Who's I play with, bro? Somebody give me a team. Let's see. What the brain is on already. In the easy looking game, man. I don't I got to do it to all your games. Hold on, let me catch my breath. I'm looking high as hell. I got to go to that shop. Oh, hell yeah. Got to get the haircut chopper. I hope. My dog, did you piss again, bro? No, can't bring them up from this thing, bro. Goddamn, boy.
Sports brings us to the banks of the Ohio River and Paul Brown Stadium in Cincinnati. The enthusiasm of this Cincinnati crowd in full effect a moment ago as their Bengals took the field.
I'm about to bust field, but fuck this vehicle here. We got the drag. As they'll match up with the Jacksonville Jaguars.
Started is Logan Cook, and we are underway from Cincinnati. The former second round pick, this is Joe Mixon.
Stop playing.
Welcome to the party. First carry of the game. How about that?
And just think, as far as he's concerned, he's just getting warmed up.
Play action. It's Burrow. He's going to go up top for the And this one almost intercepted. Had a chance to come down with it in the end zone,
but could not hang on.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Now Burrow.
Incomplete.
Interception in the end zone, probably should have been. Third down coming up.
I think that to the wrong Nathan.
On third down, Burrow. Eluding the pressure right. That's taken in by Higgins. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two.
Down defensively because they have him stacked up third and long. And you know the process had to be. Just make the tackle in front of the sticks and force the three. Instead, they've had him room to run. And now they're facing first and goal, looking to regroup.
Mixon will take this Cincinnati. Let's make no bones about it. On paper, they're the
Bengals.
At home, that's a strong opening drive.
And just think how many times we've seen this type of a matchup. Just what you said, better team at home should steamroll them. And we've seen it go the other way.
Sometimes they
buy into it and understand we are the better team. Let's go out and prove it right now.
After the touchdown, McPherson trying to kick this one away. From his end zone, here comes Agnew. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially. So a net gain of one there.
This nigga I'm playing right now. A single to game champion like Rob Beachy, you got pop up on the screen.
3.5 to go. But I just brush go up. So. They'll run it. This is James Robinson.
He's a game player for Robinson.
Way up past the 30. 5 yards remain on second down. Hurry
up. There's two on him this time.
Play action. It's Lawrence.
I'm about to bust this way. Oh!
And Shark calls it in.
I'm trying to switch the game. This is just shy of the 40.
So they'll come up in Bengals territory now with a first and 10 at the 41. They'll run for the first time with Travis Etienne. Just a yard on the pick up there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
I wish he would have called his slant right here and pick it off. Oh, that slant up there. Yeah, he changed that route, boy.
Now Lawrence. Contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well.
Picked
off at the 24.
Big ass 75 for catching.
And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line. That time defensively looked like they showed quite a bit of pressure, but backed off. And it proved fruitful. They get the pick.
Hop on Madden with this.
About getting rid of the ball quickly because he read blitz. He saw all those people stacked at the line of scrimmage, and then they fooled him by dropping into coverage. Now he's ready to get rid of the ball fast, but guess what? Too many defenders out there. Exactly as you described, an interception.
Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
I think we can all understand what they're thinking right now. They take over the ball and field goal range after the turnover, so they've got that in their hip pocket. But they've got to go for the end zone and turn this into a bigger point. Their thinking is,
I hope that's
a touchdown
not that
is really what they should get from starting here. Getting 3 points at the end of this drive, that would feel disappointing.
So from second and long, now we go to third and very manageable.
Yeah, they love that phrase, don't they? Because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance in guessing. Because you don't have to throw it. You can come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're in four down territory, that really opens.
Touchdown! Joe Burrow with a touchdown connection. And the Bengals have taken a 13-0 first quarter lead. Extra point by McPherson, up and good, and it's now 14-0.
Yo, bye. Bye, DC, buddy. You got this 5-10, right?
So after the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away.
I'm going to text you like.
From his end zone, here comes Agnew.
Or Instagram.
And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together Charles a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception, they finished up the drive. That does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Flush to his right. Now on the run. He'll throw it back deep over the middle. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call. Well, this crowd does not like that call.
understandable reaction from them. That's their team that the penalty is going against. But you and I both know they're going to take care of the quarterback.
Lawrence with the handoff to Robinson. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. A play fake for Robinson. Now Lawrence.
That's crazy.
Taken down by the Bengal pressure. The Clemson product DJ.
I'm trying to get 10 and get the put today. I'll do that.
You can't afford too many plays that go in the wrong direction like that one.
Yeah, when you take a good look at it broadly, sacks are better than giving up an interception. But where they are on the scoreboard, they've got to get rid of all of that and just create positive plays for themselves in order to have a chance.
Oh, he's touching it too.
Marvin Jones.
Yeah, fine.
And they're going to have this way down in Cincinnati territory. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Running out of the gun with ETN. And he couldn't quite First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. They go play action now. Lawrence.
Man, what the fuck is my spare?
Touchdown, Jaguars. Dan Arnold there to make the grab. And the Jaguars are back within a score. Point after, right down the middle. And that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Bengals drive about to get going. Now right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of seven past the 30 to the 32. On second down, here's Mixon. And some room to roam now. And oh, so close as he takes it all the way to the 2 yard line.
Brad cannot stop me. I'm
rushing for him. It's been tough to stop here this first half. They scored touchdowns on drives one and two, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3 for 3 to start. Mixon trying to punch it in. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown, you're without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
You tried it, real fast. And this ain't going to pop off.
On second and goal, Burrow. That's to Chase. He's got it. Touchdown, Cincinnati. Jamar Chase there to make the grab, and the Bengals add on to their lead. So simple math here in the first half, they've had three drives offensively and they have scored every time and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right?
But
this is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
Excellent. McPherson up and good, and it's now 21-7. To the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. This fielded right at the goal line. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line.
I'm streaming the Madden right now.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes.
He'll
be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7. Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. A reminder coming up in a couple of minutes' time. We'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman, the coach in our EA Sports studios. They'll have a look back at the next-gen stats from this first half of action. They got two of the three they needed there. Leaves them with third and just a yard. They go play action with Lawrence. Man open, here is Jones. This way down in Cincinnati territory. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Flushed out right. And a dump off here to Robinson. And he can't quite get there. Tackled down at the one. This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. They'll try and run. This is Robinson. And this time he is in. James Robinson. Fine work there on the touchdown run. And the Jags get a late score here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point right down the middle. And that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. After the touchdown, Cook now to kick this one away.
All right, y'all. I'm not supposed to touch on this one play real fast. Everybody sing my theme song. I was just singing it. It's going to be all the way turn.
Somebody scored this one play right now. And with a 7-point lead, they'll likely look to take this to the locker room and not really press the issue.
I'm not here on that. I'm fucking right here on that.
And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away.
That was on that, though.
Now that'll bring up second down.
And I can see the officials kind of looking at each other down there, silently wondering, does this meet the level of grounding? Fortunately, he did have a receiver in the area, but I have seen less obvious doorways.
I had him by two still. I had R1, I threw up on too late. But the I am about to say the users was raw though.
Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football
right back because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
Oh, you feel square.
Burrow will throw. Escaping the pressure right.
Come on, Joe Barry, with that slow ass though. He can't face him. He said he's going to face
him. Drives, it ended. Touchdown. They get bogged down on drive number four.
Yeah, I don't know how excited you would be on the other side of the ball that they finally didn't score. You know, you're happy, of course, but at the same time, did you have that much to do with it, or did they just get tired?
Maybe it's just a sense of relief at this point. Fourth down. Here's Joe Burrow.
Oh, my God. Oh, I ain't got time.
As he throws, as this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete.
Pick the field, a surprising yeah, I had him, move to I go had for time.
It. Predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off.
I don't know how if I blocked him.
The Jags take over in terrific field position. And his kick is right there. It's good.
I said he could go. You better come over and bless the Bucks.
You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
With both of these offenses having their way, it's not likely they'll need to be doing a whole lot at halftime. But the defenses are definitely in need of some adjusting. And for the call of the second half, let's go back out to Brandon and Charles.
He fixed that joint. Just like me, man. I got fun.
And we welcome you back
that
now.
Hadn't got a whole eight.
Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number 4 here.
Oh God, we got the whole eight. Second half bring us as we are underway. Only got one though. Only got one flash, so I still got two. Here comes Agnew. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid and he's dropped at the 18. Every other day in it's like every other day in that big school. Anything.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive.
Oh, yeah.
And they do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do
something about it. Oh, 225
in that bitch. It's something of an important drive for them because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
Okay.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there.
Yeah, 25 on there.
Throwing it away like that. Frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing.
Just chucked it
free. Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
Again on second and 10, it's Lawrence. Eluding the pressure right.
That's a pick. I put triangle. I did not put square.
So far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure or do they play coverage on this down?
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Flush to his right.
That's a pick. He's blessing for that ball.
Appears they're going to come up empty on this first drive of the second half, still down by that slim margin.
Yeah, that's okay.
You know, when you sit and analyze it, they're not happy about what happened, having to go to the bench. But this gives them a chance to let their defense do some work while they on the sidelines go over what they're doing offensively and formulate a proper plan.
And they'll try and throw for it with Lawrence, sliding out of the pocket. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And boy, possession here turns.
I told you that's quick.
More chasing got X Factor.
Nah, they just gave me that as a star for some reason. He's dropping Warzone. Lil Wayne back.
I'm a politic and probably in a section where you're not permitted. My honey's matching my Dodger fitted, playing all goal, ain't no stopping in it. Look, salute when you see me. I bought her a CC and that was her purse. Disgusting with do for a purse, disgusting with do for the clout. I'm one of the realest, the realest
compounds.
I
thought I was caught, but all that doubt, you gotta pay my money. Salute when you see me.
Put in the car to the my runner gets you speedy. Still thugging like the days when they weren't here in my CD. Made it out of the trenches. Yeah, salute when you see me. Yeah, salute when you see me. I'm getting greedy. I blow the whole budget on me. That's on me. I'm conceited.
Because it's the last team I'm gonna hop on with y'all. This right here sound like a 3P. It's gonna be over first quarter. So. Like I'm like,
I'm
Sports, and we are at Bill Stadium in upstate New York. A few moments ago, to the delight of this Buffalo crowd, it was the Bills racing out of the tunnel as they
you got the Rams. This is the very first game, too.
The Los Angeles Rams.
Thank you.
And we are
bust it
away
in
Buffalo.
This is the very first game.
From his end zone, Isaiah McKenzie. And in hindsight,
but the Rams don't win
in
real life.
He only gets this out to
I got the
16-yard line.
Yeah, Madden right now. Oh, did everybody go to the Bills?
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10.
Mark, bro, go drop a like on the stream, bro.
Allen gonna throw. And the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. And he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds.
Look up the lights on the screen, my boy.
It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit.
You got the lights.
Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here.
My dog is Henry doing that.
Nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
You're correct.
Now the first carry for Devin Singletary. And he's got room. And they got it well across
midfield
down
to the
40 before it's all said and done.
I had two.
So the big play moves
I swear to God.
I
ain't bluffing.
For first and 10. Play action. Now
I
it's
Allen.
Him
run. Trust me.
Forced out to his left. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And finally down he goes.
Run.
As they work it inside the 10 to the 7.
I wouldn't lie to you.
The fullback comes through with a big play there.
Things are looking pretty darn good on this first drive, aren't they? Came right out, set the tone this time for the big pass play.
And if the peek behind the curtain that they gave us or their game plan, I don't think that's going to be the last one we see.
I think you're exactly right about that.
It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
What you on right now, bro?
Now Allen. And he's got it. Touchdown, Bills. Isaiah McKenzie from 6 yards
away.
And the Bills take it all the way down the field and score.
So I'm showing us up a like on the screen.
Now comes the kicking team here for the extra point. And it's 7-0 Buffalo.
That man, this girl's name, Big Baby 38, underscore 4K Trey.
To the
I'm a real teller. I'm a teller.
Taking it about the one.
I bust
and
it. I'm a real
this
teller,
to
bro. No cap.
On first down at Stafford.
I see him look back.
And his throw here is incomplete.
Big baby, 38.
Trailing by touchdown early. This offense, how
okay,
imperative
play is that.
To get points out of this drive.
Well, they feel like
you
they
don't
have
play
to
that,
go ahead and match.
I'm gonna talk down to my man like that, bro.
God, you just want to avoid three and outs. You want to be able to stay on the field for a little while, let your defense catch their breath a little bit, even if you don't score any points.
I'm dipping a little bit, bro.
Stafford's throw here, hauled in by
Cobb. Okay,
got
50
and he's got it past
for
the 30 before he's hit and dropped. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Stafford. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield.
I just got the right thing to swing right there. Look out for the pickup.
From the 50, Stafford.
I bet Lennon Jack, bro.
Here, Beckham. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
I got something. I'm also going to sit on this one. This one.
Stafford on first down. Going up top.
Man, he's creeping. What? Can't he let me jump?
Touchdown.
Bro, come on, bro.
Cooper Kupp, 36
yards. That
didn't
even let me jump, bro. Is he serious?
And the Rams are an extra point away from tying up this football
game. Is he serious, bro?
extra point by Gay is up.
This
thing
folded, bro.
Score here in this opening quarter of play. Each team's had it. Each team is scoring.
Look at this
7-7
thing folded,
here,
bro.
As the kick's away.
Damn, let me jump.
McKenzie now from his end zone.
Oh, I was gone. My teammate got in my way.
Had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
You got the right on the screen, bro.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive.
Oh, I'm going to run
to long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look close.
And that was
amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no good plays by the defense.
But Marlo, you seen that during the run?
Across midfield and inside.
Now when Burrow got that snag on me in the end zone, thank you. Don't even let me touch triangle.
The first drive, and comes right back, and he's flinging it around.
That's
really
what
well
I told you.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about
going
his
really big coach.
Yeah,
hey,
I was really impressed with that last practice we saw. When they went through two
and
they went
through the
situations.
Man.
Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this.
Yeah, I think he's sick. That's where you want to be, I think.
By his tight end. These two teams all tied after one.
Facts.
They'll run on first down with Singletary, and he'll work this forward for about three at second down. Second and seven.
What boy said, big baby, okay,
they're planning to change that soon. Only question, will they get three or six
off
out of
it? And I'm testing too. Touchdown with the dive. Stop playing.
Touchdown, Buffalo.
Stop playing with my man. You know what I'm saying?
There to make the grab, and the Bills have taken the lead.
Nice dot.
Extra point by Bass, up and good. And that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown,
oh,
Bass
boy
to kick it away.
Perfection dot, man.
Takes it at the 7. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there, call it the 26.
Look at that man's perfection.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. Going up top for Kupp. And
that boy out.
What a catch on the sideline. A big connection on that one. 33 yards.
That's a well-thrown ball right there. This is where arm strength pays off because he's got to be able
he's
to get the ball downfield
that one,
and to
good
the sideline. And that's one of the more difficult throws for a quarterback. And he put it right where it needed to be.
On first down, Stafford here. Quickly into the hands of Beckham. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line. Just shy of the 20.
Okay, Beckham.
Now a first down throw, Stafford.
That's saved. That boy thought I was glitching. He bogus. He bogus. And he quit. And he quit. How long is this run? It's only been 34 minutes. I'm out on Warzone right now. I'm going to end this game with a helpline.